Hi there, this is Dana Arcuri, author, speaker, and wellness advocate. And today's topic is about the narcissistic family dynamics and some interesting things that I have come to discover recently. And so I've always felt like this whole journey with overcoming narcissistic abuse and different challenges in the dysfunctional family, I've always thought that as each year goes by, I learned something new. And so recently I have really awoken to a few new facts. Some of them are a little bit shocking and I have mixed emotions about it. So let's start first with the dynamics of the narcissistic family. And remember now, for everyone, it could be slightly different because obviously whoever the narcissist is can make a difference in how this impacts the entire family. So for most of us, it's either our mother or father, but there are times it could be a sibling that is also a narcissist. So we might be dealing with many people in the family who are narcissistic. We might have one person in the family who is the golden child, another is the lost child. They kind of just fall through the cracks. They're kind of forgotten. They're the quiet ones. They're the ones who they know deep down that they don't want to have to suffer the wrath of the narcissist. And so they lay low. I consider them the wise one. They kind of keep quiet, keep to themselves. They don't want to ruffle the feathers, especially of the abusive narc, because they know what will happen. They'll get beat, or they'll get abused, or they'll get a mental lashing, you know, where they're verbally being abused and told horrible, horrible things. You know, there's despicable things that comes out of the narcissist's mouth. You know, you're not good enough. You're not smart enough. You'll never amount to anything. The whole fat shaming. There's just so many different things. You know, usually they will attack anyone within the family who is the most kindest, gentle, empathic person. So remember, if you are a highly sensitive person, you know, it's a great thing that that is who you are. That is what you are. You have compassion on animals. You have compassion on humans. You have compassion on just Mother Nature in general. You know, you're just a very empathic, kind-hearted soul. What happens is the narcissistic parent, and let's just say it's the mother, they will use that to hurt you. They'll find a way to make you feel like you are just too sensitive. You know, they'll shame you. They'll blame you. You're the problem. You know, this is what we get raised with. And in the family dynamics, you know, there is different people who play different roles. Nobody asks to be a scapegoat. Nobody asks to be born into a toxic environment. It's just the way things play out, unfortunately. And as I mentioned in other videos, I do believe it's generational. I don't think it's just like unexpected and just a one-time thing and it'll never happen again. Instead, I do believe that there is a generational cycle of abuse, specifically narcissistic abuse, from family to family to family. It just keeps going on. Now, in these families, it could be verbal abuse, it could be physical abuse, it could be violence, it could be sexual abuse or incest, it could be horrible triangulation in which the one parent who is the narcissist will set up their kids to hate each other. They will cause division within the family unit on purpose. They love to stir the pot. And then they step back and they watch. And they are so happy. They're so pleased with themselves that they caused dysfunction, distress, disturbances and the family, you know, because that's what the narc does. That's what they're all about, is causing psychological pain, causing a lot of confusion. And there are times, you know, in the beginning days, you know, hey, the younger years, we did not know that we were the scapegoat. We did not know that our, whether it was the mother, the father, the siblings, whoever it could have been, might be all of them. We didn't know that they were a narcissist. We did not know that. However, we saw the abuse. We saw that our pets were abused. We saw that other siblings were hurt. We saw very, very many people within the family unit who became injured, whether it was physically or mentally, from the toxic family. And it could be a cycle that just keeps going and going and going until one day, you wake up and you're just like, wow, I can't believe I didn't see this. And I know, even as I mentioned in other videos, I did not see the narcissism. I did not understand the whole thing about scapegoats, flying monkeys, triangulation, manipulation, gaslighting. I did not fully grasp until a few years ago what in the world was going on within my birth family. But when you awaken to it, all of a sudden, boom, the light bulb clicks on, the light shines onto the darkness, and you are in shock. Sometimes it is absolutely traumatizing to see everything, because you are rewalking, revisiting into the past and the past history, and you realize, wow, it was worse than what I had even imagined. And another thing is that the narcissist is so clever that they can switch roles. You may have started out with one role and then somehow ended up in a different role. You didn't ask for it. It's not your fault, but this is what happens when it comes to the toxic family unit, is that when the narcissist knows that you're going to play her game and you're going to be on her side, it's a game. It's a game, okay? They're not mature adults. They're very immature and insecure, and they want you on their side. I'll give an example. So I grew up to believe from the narc mother that my father was horrible. She told me he was a terrible man. She told me he was a cheating man. Now I look back and I think, now I know why he found another woman. Huh, who would want to be with my mother, the narc? You know, I can understand why my dad left my mother. It's all falling into place now. It's all falling into place. I get it. I so get it. But the situation is this. As a child, I didn't get it. As a child, I was extremely sad that my dad wasn't there for me. And my mom used it as fuel for her fire to get me to despise my father. My mother triangulated me and my dad. So what she would do is, for a lifetime, I am talking practically daily, she would say horrible things about my dad, malicious words, disrespectful things. Like, you don't say this. You do not, when you're divorced, you're not supposed to put your kids in the middle. You're not supposed to put your kids in the middle of your feud with your ex-spouse. But my mother did. My mother constantly would try to get me on her side, and she'd tell me, your dad didn't want you. Your dad doesn't love you. Oh, your dad found himself a new wife and has new kids. He doesn't care about you. Your dad didn't send child support. And she'd carry on and on and on. And I believed her. I was a child. Who else was I supposed to believe? That she is all I knew. My dad wasn't there. I was raised without a father. I had a deep, deep father wound. It took years and years, 50 some years, to heal that deep, raw father wound. But the point is that my mother would set me up and triangulate me with my father and say horrible, malicious, nasty, negative words. And specifically saying, he doesn't love you. He doesn't care about you. He doesn't call you because he doesn't care. He moved on. Get over him. Forget about him. My mother would call him horrible, vicious words. And this is something every day I would hear horrible things. I mean, it was so constant that I was brainwashed. I mean, I am really now opening my eyes to understand my mother brainwashed me to believe that my dad didn't care about me, that my dad didn't want me, that my dad was a bad person, he was a horrible man. And if that's not bad enough, my mom used like a generalization with men, just in general. Men suck. Men are awful. Men are cheaters. You can't trust men. Never trust a man. They're always going to cheat on you. Don't do this and don't do that. And don't get fooled by that man. And, you know, she would constantly have extremely toxic things and her own false beliefs about men. You know, it's so stereotypical. You know, think about it. The narcissist is so furious that someone wised up and ended the relationship with her. And she is so furious that she will stir the pot and get everybody on board to believe, pity party her. She's the victim. She's the victim. Oh, woe is her. Oh, woe is her. And that my dad's the bad guy. In the meanwhile, maybe he walked away because he was tired of getting verbally abused by her. Maybe he walked away because he couldn't stand living with a narcissist. Maybe he walked away because she beat the shit out of him verbally every single day. And he reached the end of his rope and said, enough is enough. And he walked away because he needed to start a new life. And he did. He started a new life. But we have to understand, I was brainwashed. And so this is what's going on in the family dysfunction, that oftentimes our narcissistic parent will triangulate us with someone, whether it's the grandparent, the aunts, the uncles, the friends, the neighbors, the brother, the sister, or all of them. I mean, really? I mean, I am seeing things in a new light, and I am understanding things in a whole new way. And I'm a bit blown away that I didn't realize it 20 years ago. I mean, I really honestly now feel that my mother stole my dad from me. Whoops, my lighting just kind of, I don't know what's going on with my lighting, people. Hang on, sorry if my lighting's kind of, it's kind of going on and it's kind of going off. Anyways, let's get back on track. I believe that my mother purposefully used a lot of triangulation to get me to feel that my dad didn't love me, that he didn't want me, that I was unimportant, that I was not worthy, that I wasn't good enough for him, and that he didn't have any reason to want to have a relationship with me. And so I had a deep father wound, and it injured my relationship. My mother sabotaged my relationship with my father, and now he is gone. He passed away last year. And all I could say is, you know what? What goes around comes around. Because I did at some point come to a place of realizing that my dad does love me. And my dad did want me. And my dad and I re-reconciled several years ago. And I am so thankful today that I listen to that little place, that innate place within me, that gut instinct in me that said, give him another chance. Go visit him. Talk to him. Let's find out how things really are. And my dad spent a lot of time with me, and he used words of edification, and he had remorse and apology and asked for forgiveness. And you know what? My mom can never take away the truth, because the truth is, oh, here comes the choo-choo train. If you hear a noise in the back, it's a train. My mother can't take away that my dad loves me. My mother can't take away that my dad and I did reconcile. And for my sisters who tried to rain on my parade, my toxic siblings who were malicious, who said that my dad, you know, oh, he didn't know what he was talking about. Oh, you know, carrying on like he was in a psychosis. You know what? He was in a very sound mind during part of the time when we were together. And I admit he has Alzheimer's. I admit there were times he was not thinking clearly, but there were times when he did have a moment of clarity, of focus, when he said, Dana, Dana, it's you. And he was so happy to see me. And this is the kind of memory I'm holding on to, because those narcissists and the toxic siblings, you can't take that from me. You can't take that from me. I have peace because my father and I reconciled and nobody could steal that from me. And I want to end with this. This week I found out something new. And it's because of, again, there's just like layers and layers, just like an onion, that are peeled away, and new layers of old history and old trauma start coming to the surface. It kind of rising up. And I realized, okay, this is crazy, 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 but this is it. I'm telling you, I see things now. Oh boy. I used to be the golden child. Okay, I started really thinking about it this week, and for a long time I was trying to piece together all the people in the family, the siblings, what their little role was a long time ago and what it is now. Oh, things have changed. Oh, a long time ago I was the golden child. My mom loved me. My mom and I were best friends. My mom and I were constantly like two peas in a pod. But what happened was, when I woke up to her narcissistic abuse, I became the scapegoat. So if you feel this way, if you feel like roles have changed, share with me. If you feel like the dynamics in your family were also quite toxic and roles are changed, triangulation ruined your relationship with people, please share with me and go to danaarcurie.com for more inspiration. Bye-bye.